Good afternoon, everybody. Nick here. It is 1:30 on this Wednesday, December 8th. A cold, cloudy day in Lebanon. But thankfully, there is no snow in the forecast for today. Or if there is, it'd be very little. It is Advent week 2, and week 2 is peace. So building on what we talked about last week, we're also going to think about how do we make peace with ourselves and the peace that God gives to us in Jesus. A couple of announcements before we begin. One being, this Saturday, December 11th, Josh and I will be going to Boston for Christmas in Boston. It is a little shop in Faneuil Hall. We'll be checking that out and working our way towards Fenway. And we'll be taking them to the Bleacher Bar to wrap it up. Also, coming up at the end of the month, I'm going to do my top 10 moments of 2021. That'll be in PowerPoint format. It'll be the good, the bad, and things that we can look forward to. So without further ado, we come to him today in this Christmas season. As we begin with, O Come All Ye Faithful, 249. Please rise. Sing all ye citizens of heaven. Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him, Christ the Lord. Yeah, Lord, we greet Thee, born this happy morning, Jesus, to Thee. Flesh appearing, oh come, let us adore Him. Oh come, let us adore Him. Oh come, let us adore Him, Christ the Lord. Lord, our Heavenly Father, we come to You today. It is week two of our journey to that manger. We come to You today with joyful hearts and minds. The season of Advent brings excitement, and just the whole Christmas season, families coming together, seeing our loved ones that we may not have seen for quite some time. We would ask God that by Your Spirit and in Your Word, You would walk with us this day as we crown You in many crowns, this day and every day. In Jesus' name, amen. Crown Him with many crowns. Number 45. In celebration. Crown Him many crowns, the Lamb upon His throne. Hark how the heavenly anthem drowns all music but its own. Awake, my soul, and sing of Him who died for thee, and hail Him as thy matchless King through all eternity. Crown Him Lord of life, who triumphed o'er the grave, who rose victorious in the strife for those He came to save. His glories now we sing, who died and rose on high, who died eternal life to bring, and lives that death may die. Crown Him Lord of Heaven, one with the Father known. Father known, one with the Spirit through Him give from yonder glorious throne. All hail, Redeemer, hail, for Thou hast died for me. Thy praise and glory shall not fail throughout eternity. Very good. Please be seated. So the anthem today is A Winter's Song.
Please,
All right. Thank you, choir. That was very pretty. So we come to the place of prayer. It's another area where we can find peace, where we can bring our lives and the lives of others that we know. I don't know if you heard the news, but this past week we found out Wilbur has a tumor on his spleen. And obviously we found out he had some other issues going on as well. So we want to pray that he, you know, gets the help he needs and he can live in whatever way he can. We also want to think about what this means. We found out UPS came to an end today, and we'll talk about why in the message. We want to think about how important it is to have this time. And more importantly, what next semester will look like moving forward. So with all that in mind, the prayer song today is Spirit Song. And I apologize if I become emotional here today. So Spirit Song 384. Lord, this afternoon, we come before your throne. Trying to make peace with ourselves and make peace with others. In this Advent season, we can think about all the good gifts that you give us. A home to live in, a job, a new relationship, our dear pets that we love so much. But more importantly, you give the gift of yourself that we can pray to you whenever the situation or whenever we want. This past week has been a triumph. So much emotional baggage. Father, we found out this morning that UPS came to an end, and we know why. No routes available in this area. And also, still need help with figuring out what is appropriate conversation and what isn't appropriate conversation when on the job. It is good that they said that that was not the reason why things came to an abrupt end. But we will have opportunity again when the time comes. A little bit closer to home, we pray for the following. Lord, as always, continue to be with continue to be with Charlie and the hope and the gift that of him, that you would encourage him to reach out and at least make peace. Make peace with ourselves, and we can have some closure. Lord, we would pray for Wilbur and hope that this tumor that's in him, that you would erase it, that by your Spirit you would just encircle it and remove it from him, remove it from his body. We would pray, God, that too, that we don't want any other tragedies in 2021. It'd be sad to lose a dear friend, granted a four-legged furball, who loves us so much and we love him dearly. We would pray that you would help us in whatever way you can. We would continue to pray for Josh Rotella and his search for a new job, that he would find employment. We would also pray for Josh Arnold in Enfield and hoping that you can encourage him to reach out and know that the gift that was given was only a way to make amends for some things that were done. But no matter what, we know that we can always make amends with you, and we can always set it right. And at this time, I invite the viewers at home to lift up those that are on their hearts. So, Father, it is to that end. We thank you for Wilbur, Lenny, Willow, and Milo, and all Boston Terriers out there. We thank you for the Freeney family. And we can be thankful for our loved ones. And we are so grateful to have Josh Rotella in my life. So it's to that end, in that prayer that you taught us, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power. So with negativity comes positivity. And that positivity is the gift that he provides for us in our lives. Whether it's a vaccine, a new job, a new relationship, and our dear friends. Yes, Wilbur, we're talking about you. And please say good afternoon to everybody's favorite Boston, Wilbur. Wilbur, say hello. Did you go see Grandma? Oh, we're all sleepy. Yes, he's absolutely adorable. So, the offertory today is I invite you to subscribe to this channel and really think about this message that I have coming up shortly. So the offertory today is almost there. And will the ushers please come forward as we receive the afternoon's gifts and offering.
Thank you.
Please rise. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen. Lord, we are almost to that manger. Where the Virgin Mary carries Jesus. But for now, take these gifts and multiply them and make yourself known throughout the world as we look for a new job and new car and a new hope. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. All right. So now we're going to talk about what this second week of Advent is all about. Galatians chapter 5. Starting with verse 19. It is obvious what kind of life develops out of trying to get your own way all the time. Repetitive, loveless, cheap sex, a stinking acclimation of mental and emotional garbage, frenzied and joyless grasp for happiness, drink of God's magic show religion, paranoid loneliness, cutthroat competition, all-consuming yet never satisfied want, a brutal temper, and impotence to love or be loved, divided homes and divided lives, small-minded and lopsided pursuit, the vicious habit of depersonalizing everyone into a rival, uncontrolled and uncontrollable addictions, ugly parodies of community. I could go on. This isn't the first time I have warned you, you know. If you use your freedom this way, you will not inherit God's kingdom. But what happens when we live God's way? He brings gifts into our lives, much the same way that fruit appears in an orchard, things like affection for others, exuberance about life and serenity. We develop a willingness to stick with things, a sense of compassion in the heart, and a conviction that a basic holiness permeates things and people. We find ourselves involved in loyal commitments, not needing to force our way in life, able to marshal and direct our energies wisely. So let's talk about what that means. A little bit of backstory. We found out this morning that UPS came to an end. And the reason for that is one of two reasons. One, there were no routes available in the Lebanon area anymore. and all the other routes were filled up. Also, there were conversations in the truck that made some of the drivers uncomfortable with some of the things that I was talking to them about. More importantly, we were talking about the situation with Charlie that seems to have carried over into every area of my life now. No matter what we could be doing, it continues to appear. And the question becomes why? Why is it we can't make peace with that? The answer is because there was no closure. There was no real answer of why this happened. Now, obviously, we could sit here and think about it and come up with about a million reasons why. But we don't have time for that. And how do we make peace with ourselves in that situation? The answer? We find somebody new. And that is what I have done with Josh. He has come along and opened up a lot of windows. Just think about that. For 3 visits. That is impressive. To be welcomed into his home week after week and not have to worry about certain things, that's making peace. So how do we make peace with the sudden pause of UPS? Well, we learn from it. Knowing that, okay, this had nothing to do with us. The conversations that were had, that had nothing to do with the pause. So we will have opportunity again to do it again. We don't have to turn in my vest. We can just keep it. And when things open up, they will obviously let us know. I am not the only one, by the way, that got that same message. A lot of other people did too. So those are 2 things that easily we can make peace with. Think about what I said at the top. Taking Josh to Boston on Saturday. That's a good thing. Extra money coming in for that new car. That's a good thing, too. So those are things that we can control. Now, there are things that we can't make peace with. Like when we went to the emergency vet on Thursday with Wilbur, we almost thought that we were going to have to put him down. We don't want to do that. And thankfully, he's not at that stage. We have been doing everything that the vet has told us to do. Keeping them under observation. and enjoying those moments with him. Here's what got me a little perturbed with Pastor Tom. So I had asked him last Thursday if he could put him on the prayer list for, you know, Sunday. Well, I watched the video of it, but it was not there. Why? Then I realized that that was the same thing that was going on when I was going to church. These things happen. And we have to find a way to make peace with ourselves before we can make peace with others. Obviously, eventually, all will be forgiven and peace will be made. But for now, we sit and we wait. But he's right in what he says here. It is obvious what kind of life develops out of trying to get your own way all the time. Yeah, we can't always get our own way. It becomes repetitive. And so in this Christmas season, love one another. Make peace. I don't know if you probably heard about the tragedy that occurred in Oxford, Michigan last week. What a horrifying situation. That was tragic. A senseless act. For no reason whatsoever. My question is, why didn't the parents, why did the parents give him a gun? And why did he take it into school? You okay, buddy? You know, it just blows me away. It absolutely blows my mind that the world that we live in, it's yet very sickening. So make peace with yourself and make peace with others in this holiday season. Amen. And so the closing hymn today is Thou Didst Leave Thy Throne.
Throne and thy kingly crown, when thou camest to earth for me. But in Bethlehem's home was there found no room for thy holy nativity. Oh, come to my heart, Lord Jesus, there is room in my heart for thee. Heaven's arches rang when the angels sang, proclaiming thy royal decree. But of lowly birth didst thou come to earth, and in great humility. Oh, come to my heart, Lord Jesus, there is room in my heart for thee. Heaven shall reign and the angels sing at thy coming to victory. Let thy voice call me home, saying, yet there is room at my side for thee. My heart shall rejoice, Lord Jesus, there is room in my heart for thee. There is room in my heart for thee.
Receive the benediction. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he help you find peace in whatever endeavors life throws at you. And we will see you next week in week 3 of joy. Thank you for watching. Amen.
Let us now depart in peace, who in thy name are gathered here. Disclose the brightness of thy face, and be forever near.